This is problem number 8 for assessment number 8. And in this problem they say, graph the system of inequalities. They give you a circle, so we need to identify that this is a circle. And you know it's a circle because both x and y are squared. And remember, the circle equation is, you would call it root, well no, you'd say x minus h squared plus y minus k squared equals r squared. Now this is not the general form. The general form of the equation is x squared plus y squared equals r squared. But this is when you have a shift for the center. Because in this problem, notice that we don't have an h and a k. Well, that means that h and k are both zero, so we can say that the center for that circle is 0, 0. This is a quadratic. This has, again, an equation that is y equals a x minus h plus k. Don't forget the square there. And usually, if there's an h value, it's just a shift. But they don't have an h value, which means it's 0, comma, negative 4. This is what we would call the y-intercept for this one. All right, let's go ahead and start graphing. So I'm going to say 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. And I'm going to graph this circle. To graph the circle, we know the center is at 0. The radius, though, this says 16 right here. This is radius squared. So we're going to have to say radius squared equals 16. And square root each side, so we get r equals plus and minus 4. But we don't need to worry about a radius of a negative 4, because that can't happen, so we're going to cross that out. I can't have a negative radius. So we have a radius of 4. So we're going to mark each of these points that are 4 away from the center. And then it's a bold line, so we're going to go around in a circle. It's one of my better circles. And we need to decide, is it shaded inside or outside? So we're going to use 0, 0. So 0 plus 0 less than or equal to 16. Yeah, 0 is less than 16. So we're going to be shading this direction. Now let's go ahead and do this parabola. Well, again, negative 4 is the y-intercept. We just looked at that. Now, one little trick is to use the a value to figure out the next point, next two points. But you can't, like, do this over and over again because this is not linear, so it's not going up at a straight line. It's going at a curved line. So it only works for this a value for us to be 1 to find the first two points. We can go up 1, over 1. This is one of those points. Up 1, back 1. That's another point. And then we can start to graph it. However, I like to find the x-intercepts as well. So to find the x-intercepts, that's just finding roots, we set the equation equal to 0. So we say 0 equals x squared minus 4. Add the 4 over, we get 4 equals x squared. We square root each side, and we get plus and minus 2 equals x. So those are the x-intercepts, and I can mark 2 and negative 2. And this is a bold line, so I can go ahead and draw this quadratic up like so. Draw it here as well. And then I can determine, using 0, 0, 0 greater than or equal to 0 minus 4. 0 is greater than negative 4. So because 0 is greater than negative 4, that means 0, 0 is a solution. So we're going to be shading inside here. Well, you notice the circle's in here, this is in here. We're shading this area right there. So the first step is to be able to identify what type of inequality you're going to graph. And then use the information that you know about those inequalities to graph it and then shade it.